Well, here, some of you may have heard my dispatch yesterday. I took the day off and talked about the beautiful day and the first day that it wasn't really threatened by the weather and hanging out in the tent in my bare feet. Well, that dispatch was at 5 o'clock. Just shortly after that, heavy clouds came in the horizon, and by about 6:30, it was heavy, wet snow, really heavy snow falling hard. That lasted about an hour and a half, and then it started raining hard for an hour or more, and then the storm came in. It was a huge, huge blizzard. Came in from the northwest, and by about 10:30, 11 o'clock, it was at least 60 miles an hour. I think it was probably stronger than that. About midnight, I had faith in the tent. I was properly aligned. I always put the tent up northwest, southeast, and I'm real particular about setting the tent up to make sure that all my stakeout points are perfect, it's tied down. So I'm meticulous at setting up the tent, and I had faith that the tent would hold. It didn't show signs of any vibrations that meant it was going to disintegrate. But about midnight, I did pack up my stuff and had everything in bags, and then I have a bivy bag, too, a large bivy bag, which is like a Gore-Tex bag around your sleeping bag. So the tent does blow apart. I can still survive in the bivy bag. We use these in the polar areas, Antarctica and the North Pole. But it was an incredible storm. Woke up in the morning. Half the tent was part of a snowdrift, I mean, right up to the top. And the canoe was on the leeward side of the tent. And half the tent was, or half the canoe was totally covered up, as if someone had chopped it in half. One half of it was totally okay, and not even any snow in it, hardly. It took me about an hour and a half to dig out. I actually debated whether I really wanted to travel today. It was really strong winds, 30, 35 miles an hour, north winds. I'm heading north, and it was cold. It was zero when I woke up. But I decided to go for it, and it was a really tough day that way, but it was a really beautiful day. It was clear. I was in the middle of this large Ivory Lake when the storm hit, and I did the rest of the crossing. It was hard conditions. And then where the Phelan flowed out, the Ivory was open, and I followed that for about 4 miles. It was went around islands and channels. It was very complicated, but very beautiful. Blue water, crystal clear, white, you know, surrounded by the white snow. In areas, the snow would drift over these ridges, so it was, you know, 10 feet, 15 feet of snow drifts that would drop sheer right into the water. There was a current. And after about 4 or 5 hours or miles of that, river flows up again, and all the great travel that I had beforehand is all gone because of the storm. The first round of the rain and the heavy snow, wet snow, took care of the real fast surfaces. That's all frozen, and then the blizzard itself was a real fine snow that drifted, and that was where there was overflow. Now this light snow drifted over that, so made it a little tricky because you go through on this overflow through the soft snow. It's okay in rubber boots, but if the canoe goes into the water a little bit, it just instantly freezes in, so I had to avoid this overflow. But it was an interesting day. It's really beautiful now. It calmed down. This is one of these spring 24-hour storms that just came up. It was a kind of a Fairlands Express. And this area is noted for these storms that just come wham. They just come right out of nowhere. You have a fine day. And normally the day like today, it was the moisture that set it off. So anyways, it was a bittersweet day, but mostly sweet. And now that it's over, especially, and I'll check in tomorrow. Over and out.